SCP-1030. Object Class, Euclid. Special Containment Procedures. SCP-1030-1 is to be kept in a 7-meter by 5-meter holding cell under video surveillance and staffed by one guard. There are to be no tangible objects in the cell except one word processor terminal, to be built into the wall of the cell. SCP-1030-1 may request materials for self-repair by typing on this terminal. Staff are to place materials in the airlock between the observation booth and the holding cell, then vacate the airlock before SCP-1030-1 is given access to it. Under no circumstances should SCP-1030-1 be given any sharp objects or potential writing utensils. Any attempt by SCP-1030-1 to draw or carve SCP-1030-2 shall result in revoking of word processor privileges until later review. Any resulting instances of SCP-1030-3 should be reverted by removal of SCP-1030-2, or, if more convenient, destroyed by fire. Description: SCP-1030-1 is a humanoid figure approximately 1.65 meters tall, constructed of various objects. As of, it is composed of a pair of shoes, a computer mouse, a garbage can, 4 meters of rubber hose, crushed remains of a pushcart, a personal digital organizer, a lab coat, a pair of glasses, and objects integrated into SCP-1030-1 corrode, rot, or otherwise decompose at an accelerated rate. Heavily damaged objects are expelled and replaced by an unknown force using other nearby objects capable of roughly filling the vacated space. Objects may contort or break if necessary, but preference is given to objects requiring a minimum of effort. Ruined items are not expelled until a replacement is found. SCP-1030-1 has expressed that keeping damaged items integrated is painful. The only constant feature on SCP-1030-1 is the presence of a complex symbol, hereafter SCP-1030-2. That becomes engraved on the back of whatever analog SCP-1030-1 is using for a head. Part of the symbol includes the Hebrew word for life. SCP-1030-1 expresses periodic desire to copy this symbol onto other objects. Any object marked in this way, known as SCP-1030-3, becomes animate with some control by SCP-1030-1 as long as they are within meters of SCP-1030-1. Beyond that range, SCP-1030-3 invariably becomes hostile, seeking out and attempting to harm any humans in any way possible. Removal or destruction of any portion of SCP-1030-2 reverts such items to their original inanimate state. Recovery Notes: SCP-1030-1 was initially contained following stories of a monster near a garbage dump in Czechoslovakia. Agents captured SCP-1030-1 on using powerful magnets, as much of its body was composed of scrap metal at the time. SCP-1030-1 offered no violent resistance, attempting only to flee at first contact, and ceased its attempts after several minutes. Addendum 1030-01: Deviant Behavior, New Containment Procedures. SCP-1030-1 has begun attempting to place SCP-1030-2 on any object it can access, with mixed success. New containment procedures forbidding the presence of non-repair objects implemented due to extra security measures needed for animated furniture. Walls and floors are now padded fabric due to severe structural damage caused by animation of walls and floors. Computer terminal resolution and size have been reduced following input of ASC2 version of SCP-1030-2 that resulted in violent animation of computer terminal. Following implementation of new containment procedures, SCP-1030-1 has ceased regular movement and refused to type on terminal except for the word alone once a day.